Hey guys, Adam Savage here with not exactly a one-day build, but more like a one-day shop maintenance. I came into the shop this morning with some plans to make some stuff, and then I've been watching a lot of YouTube videos of people restoring old machines, lathes, and mills, and I decided to take apart the self-centering reversible three-jaw chuck for my mill and make it a little bit better. Basically, you know, I hadn't done that in ever. I've had this thing for eight or nine years, and I wanted to take it apart and take out all the swarf and the dirt and everything and put it back together. So that's what these time lapses show. This is me pulling off the spindle lock chuck head, putting it on my table, and slowly starting to inspect each of the parts. I also, not having any of the institutional knowledge about how to take one of these apart and put it back together. I mean, I watch YouTube videos, but frankly, for a lot of these things, the positioning of the various components of a lathe chuck can be really, really persnickety and specific. And if you get it wrong, woe betide you. You can see me here pulling out the etching pen and etching in numbers on each of the spindle lock pins so they go back exactly where they belonged. I don't know that that was necessary. It's very plausibly overkill, but again, I'd rather overkill than underkill. Once I had the pins and all the pieces knolled out on the table, then I started reassembling. But first I ran an India stone on a lot of the flat surfaces. This is not to actually sand down the surfaces, it's mostly to actually take down any burrs or dings. A lot of these parts and pieces, the main bodies of them, are made of cast iron, which is fabulous for reference surfaces, but it's soft. And if you ding it with something, that ding can actually throw it off the next time you try and put it together. You can actually see me here adding some grease and then removing grease. You can see me pulling out my grease gun and adding some grease and then immediately starting to scrape away grease. This is because I thought maybe I should just grease it because I couldn't get these the three side pins out, these guys here. And then I figured out how to get them out and I realized I should clean out all the grease. I should clean out every last bit of grease in case there's any dirt or grit in there and then put in some new grease, reassemble it, put in a nice coat of some machine oil and put it back together. And before putting it back together, I like took each part and ran it with some 400 grit sandpaper just to clean it up and make it look a little nicer. I went down to the bottom of every single hole and wire brushed out everything. It's just, like once I had the naked body of just the chuck shell, just cleaning it out with a rag feels really good. So once I started reassembling it, then it was time to put it back on the lathe and indicate it in. And that's actually, I'm using a thing like this here. This is a lever indicator for just making sure I have concentricity. And I spent about an hour assembling and reassembling the lathe chuck. And I at first when I started out, I was about 4/1000ths out of round, which is way, that's terrible. I got it down to about 3/10, 3/10,000ths out of round, which is, I believe, the acceptable range for this chuck. However, to be honest, I might want to invest in a better three-jaw chuck. This is the one that the lathe came with, and it might be nice to have a better one. Just saying. This kind of project, this sort of take the thing apart, it's one of the ways in which, again, I take the things that I utilize and I put them in my head, right? So now I've seen and touched and cleaned all the internal pieces of this chuck. I have laid my hands on them, and thus I've laid my head on them. Like I've laid my brain on them. And so now it's operation. There's nothing about it that's mysterious to me. And there's this way in which we're separated from the things that are mysterious to us, right? So before I took it apart, I kind of knew what was inside, but I hadn't seen it. Therefore, it was like a black box. And if I had errant operation, I didn't know how to deal with that. Or I didn't have a clear idea how to deal with that. Once I've taken it apart and put it back together, well, now I do have a much clearer idea about its repair and its maintenance and its upkeep and its operation. Someday I'll finish. But maybe not. Maybe, there's just an endless number of tools to connect with and wrap my head around and make tighter. And in a way, this is something that I've always done. I love telling stories about how when I first get toys, even when I was like 10 or 11 years old, I'd get a toy and I'd start to make it better. You know, I'd add some black around the wheels, or I'd take a silver pen, or I'd take it apart and put it back together, make it a little tighter. I still do that. It's a lovely operation, and it's a nice meditation, and it, you know, puts me in mind to be more in my shop. Well, there you go. I hope those time lapses were relaxing and soothing. The operation itself was certainly soothing for me. Thank you guys for joining me for this one day shop maintenance. Cheers.